Kersie, nice to have you here today.
Well, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
No, it is our pleasure having you as one of our facilitators. And I know that you're facilitating the digital marketing workshop at the SHE Brilliance inaugural event.
Yes.
So what can our participants expect from your workshop?
So before I go into that, maybe a little bit about my background, just to give context. Again, thanks for having me. I'm so honored myself as well as my company. My company is Clozette, and I started Clozette 11 years ago with three other colleagues, and we were working together before in technology media company. So 11 years ago, we came together over chili crab dinner.
Oh, wonderful. That's the best way. That is the best way.
Maybe some beer. And, and a week later, we started Clozette, right? And Clozette is a digital media for women, but it was different in that we, right from the start, we embraced and we deeply incorporated social media, user-generated content into our media. And, you know, 11 years forward today, gosh, looking back, time flies, and we have evolved a lot. Today, we call ourselves a digital marketing company, and we pride ourselves in, you know, being really good at content marketing, content that performs. So I think digital marketing is like part of our everyday life, whether it's for our own brand assets or whether it's for, you know, when working with clients and brands that we help, you know, with their marketing strategy, their marketing challenges. So I think at this workshop, really, it's a great opportunity for me to share with the audience my journey. Of course, we're going to go through the, you know, why digital marketing, right? Traditional versus digital. And even in my journey, this last 11 years, digital marketing has evolved so much. What is the current state, you know? Just alone, you know, with the pandemic, it's forced so many businesses, including ourselves, to rethink about how we go to market, right? So how do we market to our consumers? They have changed. Where are they? We can't see them anymore. So all these challenges I will talk through. I've talked through, of course, the different types of marketing, the concepts, you know, from search to email to social media marketing, influencer marketing, content marketing, engagement marketing. But I think more than that, I really want to find out from the delegates as well what is their key concerns, right? Their pain points, and we'll work on some examples together, case studies. I think share interesting, successful campaigns, but also maybe share campaigns that have failed, because I think a lot of times, I learn from failed campaigns, right? And I think it's not going to be just one way. I'm really hoping to learn from the audience as well, what's keeping them awake at night in terms of marketing or positioning their brands. And it'll be fun. I'm going to have some games, some quizzes, and debunk some marketing myths together, win some Clozette merch.
We love that.
Yes, I'll bring that along. So remember to sign up for my conference.
Oh my God, that sounds so exciting. And definitely the 90-minute session sounds like it packs a punch.
Mm-hmm.
You were mentioning about brands earlier.
Yes.
Obviously, COVID-19 has given the impetus for digital transformation acceleration.
Mm-hmm.
So when it comes to brands, how can a brand really stand out?
Wow. So I think whether you are a new business or you know, a 10-year-old business like myself, you know, sometimes you need to stick to your who you are. What is your brand identity? What is your brand story? I think you need to know what you're passionate about, what you're good at, what problem do you intend to solve, and you need to convey that, right? In your brand logo, in your tagline, in your description. And I think if you are passionate about what you do, I think that will convey to right to your audience. And you know, sometimes we ask ourselves, right, when we want to launch maybe a new service or a new product, and the market is already crowded with that same service and that same product, do we still have a chance, right? How do we then make our service stand out? And I think that there is always an opportunity too. I mean, the fact that there is like two Korean restaurants in my neighborhood, but I tend to go to one more. Why? They serve the same food, quality is about the same, but I realize that the difference is maybe in my experience when I'm there, customer service, things like that can make your brand really stand out. But then how do you tell your audience that? You need evidence, you need proof. So I think for me, really important also is customer reviews. So right from the get-go, if you're starting a new business, I believe in working on that first few case studies to show to your potential customers that you know what you're doing. So build your case studies, your customer testimonials. And I think lastly, it's easy and it's difficult, it's creativity. Mm. It's about injecting something special, something creative into the entire process. The colors that you choose for your logo, maybe a unique packaging, right? It could be simply a promotion or a deal that it's that is sincere, you know what I mean? A lot of times, I have friends telling me, the terms and the conditions, it's not a real deal. Provide a good deal that's memorable. And then I think a memorable advertisement, jingle. It doesn't have to be something you like. It could be an annoying jingle, but it stays with you. It sticks in your head. And you think about the brand, you know, when you're thinking of buying something. So, yeah.
What I love about what you share is you make it sound like it is really about common sense. Mm. I think your encouragement when it comes to for any brand, whatever you sell, we have to focus on the customer experience.
Exactly.
And then couple with what would they remember most, whether it's the color of your logo, the jingle, like you said, it's not personal. You don't have to really absolutely love it. But if people remember, then you are at the branding frame of mind.
Correct, because you have touched them or you have engaged them. Right?
Yeah. And you know, we are looking at most probably having quite a few entrepreneurs or even entrepreneur wannabe that will be attending your workshop. So for those who are new at the game, you know, starting your own business, because it's all exciting, and we know when we start our own business, you and I, we always think that, you know, our baby is the best, right? Yeah. And sometimes it may not be the case for someone who are not as invested. So how should a brand new company start looking for the audience or attracting the audience?
And I think, again, you know, the audience is such an important part of the whole entire digital marketing process. When I started my company, right, I think it's the audience equals to me, what I like. Sometimes it is, but most of the times I realize it's not really. So you really need to find out who your audience is, right? And what makes them tick? Do they, and again, there are different types of audience, right? You can't just have one type of audience. So I think the challenge, even for me, is finding out how many types of audience do I have? But then again, you know, the 80-20 rule, which audience segments do I focus on? And that's why people do have in their database their VIP customers, right? Because when you spend more time with them, you can reap better more from these customers. And for each type of customer types, you want to know how old they are, right? Where are they? And in the digital world, where are they consuming content? Where are they doing research? Where are they getting entertained? What time do they look for information? And what kind of content would resonate with them? Are they deal seekers? Or they prefer aspirational content because they can identify with your celebrity ambassador for your brand, for example. So then comes the, it's good if you have all these knowledge, but how do you actually get to know these things, right? I think for many businesses, we may not have a physical presence. So you can't be at a store and see how your customer react to the product that you have placed there or to the food you serve them. So in a digital world, a lot of times we can't feel and see the customer's reaction to your service or your product, right? But there are tools. So again, that's what I love about digital marketing. And here's where we need to get technical. There are the tools like Google Analytics is really important. I think Google Analytics by itself is an entire discipline, right? So if you want to get serious about it, you do need someone, a specialist, or you may need partners. And ourselves, we've been using social media, of course, Facebook, Instagram, and you can see also in the last 10 years how they have evolved their tools. It's become more sophisticated, which means it's also getting harder. So you really need to practice it on a day-to-day basis, you know, on how you read these numbers and and then what kind of action you can take with them, right? So there are tools, and It's interesting. I want to share that actually, even for Clozette, actually currently, like I said, in with the pandemic, we are trying to streamline some of our offerings. And my content head of content was just discussing with me, you know, Kersie, it's time maybe we look at who is our current audience set and focus on things that they like. And so we went through this exercise. First, we went to the technology, right? The platform analysis, the data to understand from that perspective. We took a step further and do like a digital online survey of our existing readers, for example. What has their interest changed? Have their time of consumption changed? Things like that. And then we took another step further and do focus group. You know, the good old focus group. Those are really important. Mm. And for the different age groups that we're trying to target, we form focus group of about 5 to 6 to 8 people. Some of them know our brand, some don't. And hear from them. What's their impression of our logo, our tagline? What do they think about the content we put out on our Facebook, on our Instagram? And we learn so much from them. And we realize that the 20-something, they are on Telegram. And the 30-something, no, they don't want to get on Telegram, you know? So with that knowledge, then how do you reach them, right? So I think that's the beauty of digital marketing. And after knowing all that, I think what I love most is, if you're still not sure, you can still test, you know, with digital marketing, A-B testing, you hear that all the time. You're not sure, like even for us, we are trying to reach out to new clients because we can't meet our clients anymore. We're doing lead generation, right? Do our clients prefer 3 hours free consultation or maybe a white paper? And we have limited time, limited budget, and you look at the results after a few days, and then you zoom in on the one that's working. So I think that's the beauty of digital marketing. You can tune, but you need to practice. You know, you need to be with it day to day, and you'll be get good at it. You know.
Yeah, I love what you shared. Again, I think you're so humble because what I hear is the fact that you are practicing what you preach. Mm. You know, even though you're an expert, you know, your organization is an expert, but you're not afraid to say, hey, we have to apply it to ourselves too, right? Because to understand, okay, has our audience changed? Because people's lives have changed over the past 18 months, right? And preferences and how they consume. The what sticks out most is you talk a lot about content marketing, right? What resonates with people. And so why is content so relevant now for digital marketing and even looking forward to the future? Do you think content marketing continues to hold the front positioning of digital marketing?
And you know, this word content marketing, I remember about maybe 5-6 years ago, it became the buzz, right? It became like, we are the content marketing company. And I think before that, we will hear often that content is king, right? And I think where I come from, my personal experience, absolutely, I think content is everything. So if I would give an analogy, right, after you have understand all the concepts and the techniques and you come up with a plan, that's like the veins flowing through your body and content is the blood, right, that's going to flow through the veins to the different parts of the body, to the different audience, right? And you have to make sure the right amount, right? So that for that whole system to work together. And you know, content marketing to me is a discipline really about knowing what's the best content for the right audience and matching their needs at every step of their customer journey. It's not easy, right? But it's simply that. And what is content? You know, simply from a piece of text, a description to a photo, a moving photo, a video series, an article, a white paper. But if that content is delivered to the right segment, you know, the right audience at the right time, at the right place, it will evoke an emotion. Your customer will feel informed, right? Feel educated. They will feel intrigued by what you have to say. They may feel inspired and they're impressed with your brand. And lastly, you know, they may take action. You know, they will call you up and say, how do I buy? So that's the end goal, right? If content marketing done right, it's magical. So come to my workshop. I'm going to share really some examples, you know, in my 11 years of journey, whether we've applied it to our own assets, right, our own media, or interesting case studies where we've worked with brands and helped brands succeed in their campaigns. Hopefully we can learn together. And I think, you know, I want to thank you for creating this platform. Oftentimes I feel that when, you know, I'm stuck at work in the office and I just forget about going out to interact with the community, right? So I think this has forced me to really put aside time to think about things, and I really hope that, you know, it's an opportunity for me to learn a lot as well. So after all, I think this is for like-minded people to come together, and hopefully we can all walk away with, you know, some ideas, but mostly, you know, motivation and inspiration to just keep on going at what we do every day.
Thank you, Kersie. We're so excited to have you, and on behalf of Kim and Kate, we are so honored to have you in our community. And in our community, we say content is queen.
All right. We'll be right back.